All right, very good. It was a big night, also, though, a sad one for the stars. We're talking the Grammy Awards and saying goodbye to Whitney Houston.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for sharing our sister Whitney with us.
Jennifer Hudson here performing one of Houston's greatest hits, of course, I Will Always Love You.
Houston, in case you haven't heard, died on the eve of the Grammys at the Beverly Hilton Hotel, where she was preparing to attend a pre-Grammy party. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Naomi Peskovitz is live in the newsroom now. Learn new information this morning, Naomi?
Well, Brad, Megan, we want to get you right to the latest this morning. The Los Angeles coroner has announced that the autopsy is complete. Still, it could be weeks before we know what killed Whitney Houston. Early reports say she may have drowned after mixing alcohol and an anti-anxiety drug. She was found dead Saturday afternoon in her hotel bathtub. Houston's only child, her daughter Bobby Christina, has now been released from the hospital. She was admitted yesterday and treated for stress and anxiety. Houston's ex-husband, Bobby Brown, arrived in Los Angeles overnight to be by his daughter's side. The Grammy Awards opened last night in prayer, several stars paying tribute to an artist who shaped the face of modern music.
There is no way around this. We've had a death in our family.
I just want to say to Whitney up in heaven, we all love you, Whitney Houston.
And ABC News has learned a variety of pill bottles were found inside Houston's room at the Beverly Hilton. In 2009, Houston admitted she'd been using cocaine and marijuana for years. There are also reports of erratic behavior in her final days, and we'll have more on that in the next half hour. Reporting live in the newsroom, Naomi Peskovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.